Thank you, respected Chairman. I have been asked to speak on enhancing water use efficiency through per drop more crop. In the inaugural session, we have already discussed about the importance of water and how efficiently we can utilize for irrigation purpose in agriculture. So time given is 8 minutes, as I was listening, Mr. Rana. So I will try to sum up within 8 minutes. So here, I will not tell much about that. I have already discussed about that food and nutritional security aspect is required to be taken care. And agriculture has made a rapid stride and green revolution past success, everybody knows. But at that time, we were having enough land which was available with us. Few genes, they did wonder, and we could increase our production, and that was celebrated as a green revolution, I should say. Then lesson learned were from that intensive agriculture were that we need to make judicious use of land, water and pesticide. So here I will only underline water aspect, because water is the only water is the theme area of today's conference. So I will speak about water, and here considering the importance of available water, Government of India started the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana. So through this presentation, I would like to give an insight about the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana, that under this program, what kind of aspects have been taken and how we are going to make the best utilization of the water. So first aspect, because it's an end-to-end approach, end-to-end solution which this PMKSY provides, and here we have an integration of all those aspects, that how those water resources can be best charged and those can be further through distribution network could be moved towards you can say field. So already there are several terminologies, har khet ko pani and jal sichan, jal sanchan, such kind of words you might have heard. So har khet ko pani is that will be covered through that distribution system, that water should go to each and every farm, so that physical access should be there. So then the available water, how we can best utilize, that will come under the water use efficiency. So that will be through per drop more crop, we call it, through drip irrigation system and sprinkler irrigation system, whatsoever water is available, that will be utilized from that that mode. So here budget allocation was 50,000 crore. This is for 5 years. This is a 5-year plan. And again, three ministries are involved into it. Department of Agriculture and Cooperation and Farmers Welfare under Ministry of Agriculture, then Department of Land Resources, then Ministry of Water Resources. So here three ministries and four departments are involved into it, and various components which are the important part of PMKSY are this AIBP, this is a then again accelerated irrigation benefit program, then per drop more crop, har khet ko pani, that is again distribution system further, then watershed, that conservation program. These are the four major components of this Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana. And here the major focus is on district level planning. So district level planning has been made so far. 100 districts have been covered, and we have planned to cover 530 more districts into it. So under this PMKSY, this assessment of the water potential, then analysis of the cropping pattern, district level coordination mechanism, and leveraging public and private sector, these are the major thrust areas which are being now taken care in this part. So here you can see that this is a open irrigation, is flood irrigation we call it. So a lot of water is wasted through this irrigation system. Then this is the drip irrigation system we want to promote, and we are promoting through the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana. So here, as I have mentioned in the morning, that 80% of the water is needed for irrigation purpose. This micro irrigation technology has its benefit. We can save the water, we can save the energy, and then again reduction will be towards labor cost, fertilizer cost, then yield enhancement has also been recorded, because we need to provide the water whatsoever quantity is needed. So excess quantity, there will be loss, it will be evaporated, or plant will again through transpiration losses will occur. So in general, हम लोग भी कहते हैं कि अगर हम लोग सात आठ ग्लास पानी पी लेते हैं उसके बाद ठीक है हम लोगों का क्लिंजिंग इफेक्ट रहेगा लेकिन प्लांट के लिए वो सिस्टम एप्लीकेबल नहीं होगा वहाँ प्लांट के लिए तो इफ़ यू आर गोइंग मोर गिविंग मोर वाटर बट इट नीड्स ओनली लेस व्हाट्स एवर इज नीडेड इट शुड बी प्रोवाइडेड टू इट सो इट इज नीडेड फॉर यू कैन से ट्रांसलोकेशन ऑफ द न्यूट्रिएंट्स फ्रॉम सोयल टू द प्लांट सो हियर जस्ट आई वॉन्ट टू मेंशन दैट ए टास्क फोर्स वॉज कंस्टिट्यूटेड इन द ईयर 2004 एंड 690 लाख हेक्टेयर आई मीन 69 मिलियन हेक्टेयर लैंड देयर इज अ पोटेंशियल टू ब्रिंग अंडर द माइक्रो इरिगेशन सिस्टम बट सो फार वी हैव कवर्ड ओनली 8.7 मिलियन हेक्टेयर लैंड दैट हैज बीन ब्रॉट अंडर ड्रिप इरिगेशन सिस्टम एंड अवर प्लान इज दैट बाई द एंड ऑफ 2021 वी नीड टू bring another about 20 lakh hectare area 2 million hectare area will be added into it so this is a drip irrigation system here it's a kind of layout so this is a perfect layout is there and that is based on the spacing requirement of a particular crop so crop based technologies are already there and those technologies have been worked out and those technologies are time and again passed on to the farmers that they need to adopt it Then the most important thing is that through this micro irrigation system, there will be saving of 40% to 60% of the water, and yield increase has also been observed. 60% to 100% yield increase has been. So some people will say that why yield increase? How this yield increase has happened? Because if we do flood irrigation, we are going to create more, relative humidity. That humidity will be more around that plant. And then diseases and insect pests will attack the plant. So here we are going to minimize the incidence of diseases and pests. So here through micro irrigation system we are providing moisture to the plants in the root zone. Then again, one more system is there. It's called as fertigation. Through fertigation, we are in that water only we provide the nutrients and nutrient efficiency will increase, water use efficiency will automatically increase through that. So these are the kind of fertigation system. I will not speak much about that. These are the targets, financial targets, because these we discussed with in the Niti Aayog. Then Niti Aayog asked us to give a roadmap. Then I provided the roadmap that in the particular year, how much area we will cover. So this is the roadmap which we have already discussed and we have provided. This is the kind of assistance which we provide to the farmers. So 40% is now you can say 60% subsidy is there for small farmers, and 45% subsidy is for the other farmers I should say. So again we have focus on the means desert prone areas and those areas. In those areas we provide more subsidy. So for northeastern hilly regions again subsidy ratio is more, subsidy support is more. And we have worked out all guidelines are available with us that for different spacing, how much cost will be involved for sprinkler system, what should be the cost. So here we have covered 86.9 lakh, I mean around 8.7 million hectare area has been covered. And you can see the progress year-wise, then again state-wise, you will find that few of the states, they are the good performer, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, these are the states which are the good performer, but there are bad performing states also. We have Punjab, Haryana, because enough water is available with them, so they are utilizing underground water also. Now many of the districts, they have fallen under the dark zone. So we need to avoid that. Our focus is in those areas. Kerala, they have never demanded for drip irrigation system. So Jammu Kashmir, they have never demanded for irrigation system. But now we are forcing them that our area expansion program that will only be supported with drip irrigation system. So this kind of support is there. This kind of interventions now we are now making. So here, management into information system has been developed that I will not discuss, but on this slide I would like to just spend 1 or 2 minutes, 1 minute only I will spend. You can just see that what kind of water requirement is there. So once I was asked, can you tell me that how much water is needed if we provide through flood irrigation system. Then let us take example of banana. But banana is a crop which needs high water. So high water requirement is there for banana. 90,000 liter of water is needed in 1 hectare of land in one irrigation, 6 centimeter up to depth if we wet the soil. So, but if you use the drip irrigation system, we can minimize, and the water needed will be 48,000. So 50% cut will be there. So again, there are few states we analyze that why this area expansion is not happening, why people are not adopting this drip irrigation system, sprinkler irrigation system. Then it came to our notice that there are few areas which are distantly located, and again power supply is not continuous. So if we can provide a kind of solar driven systems, then I think efficiency will increase and people will adopt this. So now we have linked it with MNRE program. So Ministry of Natural and Renewable Resources, now we have linked it and we have opened it at the farmers. They can adopt, they can take benefit of that scheme, and here some kind of calculations were made that for a particular crop, what power of that particular solar system should be there. So these informations were developed. Now you see, these are the water guzzling crops. Sugarcane is a water guzzling crop. It needs a lot of water. So here drip irrigation system has been successful. I will quickly run the few slides and I will just come to an end. Banana, again, it is a water guzzling crop. Cotton, but it is grown in the dry belt, but it can be. Now drip irrigation system has been successful in this case. A lot of experiments have been made. Again, tur, this is a pigeon pea. Again, it's one of the pulse crop which takes around 180 to 200 days. So here, through drip irrigation system, high water use efficiency is now attained. Then again, pomegranate. These all are the success stories. So through our these programs, we have National Horticulture Mission, Horticulture Mission for North Eastern Hills. So today, in the country, all orchards of grapes and pomegranates, 100% of the orchards, they have drip irrigation system in the country. So this kind of progress has now taken place. Then again, this is another crop. So our action plan is that we want to cover these 530 districts, I have told you. Then through this micro irrigation, again, this is the approach which we want to. I have just forgotten to include one more slide. I will read out. I have already mentioned that few of the states are bad performers, so few of the states are good performers. For good performers, we need not to worry. Our worry is for the bad performing states. So our focus is on those states that they need to implement these schemes, and area expansion will only be supported if they have irrigation, this drip irrigation system in their fields, farms. Then cropping system approach also we are following. We are recommending that yes, these are the technologies, these are the crops which needs less water, and those crops are required to be chosen for cultivation in those areas where is the scarcity of the water. Then selection of the crops, as I have mentioned, then suitable agronomical techniques, cultivation techniques. So we have that region flow method. So we recommend region flow method, and now for pulses, large scale adoption has happened, and farmers, they have adopted that technique, and still we are educating the farmers that they need to adopt these techniques. And plastic culture, use of plastic culture, mulching, etc., so that we can conserve the water, and through drip irrigation system, and then again through mulching, if we support them, then we can maximize the efficiency and that water whatsoever we are going to apply to the plants that will be applicable. So here what we need to ensure the efficient use of water extension services. That's one point. Then again, we need to focus on some of the areas through cropping, through adoption of the cropping system models, and suitable agronomical techniques are also required to be followed. And definitely with this approach, we are optimistic and we are confident that in the coming years, area will increase. But without the support of states, things will not happen. Thank you very much. So this is my presentation, which I tried to summarize.